Hi, welcome to my channel, the Machine Learning Engineer. Today I will introduce you a new technique for memory optimization, this time only for inference. And the designers or the creators of this package, this and also this research paper, they create a library, AIR LLM, and they claim to and say that they are able to run a 70 billion models in a 4 gigabit domestic GPU. I can tell you just at the beginning that it's possible, and I will explain you now how they can do it and what are the pros and cons of this. Before to start, I will introduce you as well. This is a topic that we already discussed in the channel in a previous video, where we discuss techniques for memory optimization and also some of the new techniques that the researchers are introducing on the new model architectures, like especially on how the attention heads are organized, and also how quantization, the technique that techniques to reduce memory footprints, either at training or inference time. As you remember, I will give you just a small refresh of what we cover, just to give you some background, and then on I will present you how this people is doing, and you will get probably, and also with the demo I will present you. You will see the what are the pros and cons to use this technique. At the end you can use it at home in your personal computer or in your laptop. If you have a GPU, you don't need even a GPU of 4 gigabytes, depending on the size of the model. And you will see later how it's done. So you remember in the video, in this video I present. Weeks ago, where we discussed the quantization, just briefly, from 1 gigabyte of memory, just to be loaded in floating point 32 bits in memory in the GPU, you need for 1 billion, you need 4 gigabytes in 32 bits full precision. And if you want to do training or fine tuning, where you do the phase of the feed forward and back propagation, you need additionally another 20 gigabytes just for do the calculations, keep the gradients on temporary space, etc. So you need at least for 1 billion, you need 24 gigabytes approximately in 32 bits full precision, and if you do inference per 1 billion, you need 4 gigabytes. So, for example, in my domestic GPU, barely I can do inference with a model of 1 billion parameters. So, quantization at the end is this technique that allow us to. Let me check where I have it. Allow us to reduce the memory footprint either at inference time or our training or fine tuning time. How we do it? Well, just reducing the precision of the data type. We reduce if we use floating point 16, we reduce 50%. If we use 8-bit data type, we reduce up to 20%, and if we use the 4 bits, we reduce another 50%. So it's the minimum up to now that we can reduce to the cost of reducing the precision of the data type. Also, keep in mind that it's not possible to use some of this quantization in, for example, in images. We cannot use the 4 bits for now. Probably it will be, discovered some other techniques that allow us to use these small data types with images, but for the time being, still, or at least I didn't find anybody who discovered this how to do it with images. It's applied to to language for now, but well, this is the way that to now everybody was trying to reduce the memory footprint and allow us to, well, to use a cheaper hardware to fine tune, train, or do inference of our LLMs, no? And then and again, the con of this technique is that we are reducing the precision, and somehow we are reducing the accuracy of the models. What these people have been done? One second, let me find the notebook. So these people, they are reusing a technique that we are already using to persist the model in this. It's the model sharding. The model sharding is breaking the or splitting the layers of the model in chunks, and then these chunks are the shards, and this every shard contain a one or multiple layers of our model, no? And then this allow us to split the model among different GPUs, and when we are training or fine-tuning a model, different layers are in different GPUs. There is other process which later on synchronize gradients and calculations, but it's the only way that we had today to train and fine-tune large models, even being quantized. The only way to do it is sharding the model and dividing the model across different GPUs. But that happens only at training time. When we do inference, as you probably know, when we only do feed forward, and we are not doing backward propagation. What does this mean? That the model, the data enter into your model from the input layer, and sequentially move layer by layer up to you get the output layer and you get one token. So every time if you want to generate a token, you input your data, in this case the prompt, in a generative case, in a generative model, the prompt enter the data, enter the model through the input layer, and sequentially is doing do the calculations, the model do the calculations in the input layer. The output of these calculations go to the second layer in this representation. In the second layer do other calculations, and the output of the second calculations go to the third calculation or output layer in this case, and give you the first token. To generate the second token, you do the same, no? You introduce the input data plus the token generated. You make the calculations on the first layer, the output of these calculations go to the second layer, do the calculations, and the output of the second layer go to the output layer, make the calculations, and you generate the second token. And then, depending on the number of tokens, this process repeats up to you get the maximum number of tokens that you want to generate. And then, as you can see here, the process is sequential, and up to the calculations that you had done in the first layer have not been done, you don't need the rest of the neural network. And then what these people have been done is, okay, if I don't need this, for example, in this representation, the layer number 2 and the output layer, why to have it in memory? They don't have it in memory. That is what they have done. The technique is essentially they split the model in layers. When you initially load the model, they had been created an auto model. This is loading the model from Hugging Face or from Dix, and what they do is just split the model into layers and serialize it to Dix, and then at inference time they will take first of all the first layer, they will load it in memory, they will make the inference, they will drop the layer from memory, and they will load the second layer in memory, do the calculations, drop the layer from memory, load the last layer in memory, do the calculations, and in this case we generate the first token. The process starts again. To generate the second token, we load the first layer in memory, do the calculations, drop the layer from memory, we load the second layer into memory, into the GPU in this case, do the calculations, drop the layer, and we load the third layer or the output layer into memory, and we do the calculations, we generate the second tokens, and the process continue up to you generate the number of tokens that you specified on the parameters of you in the generate method. This technique obviously allow you to load, because you are only loading one layer in memory, allow you to load in a very small GPU, how to say, a layer, and do the inference. You don't need the others, because as you know, as I explained you before, and you also know that you don't need the others at two, they are not needed, because the process is sequentially from beginning to end, from input layer to output layer. Advantages, obviously, you can run a very large model, so you just need to consider what is the biggest layers in number of nodes, the biggest layer in numbers of nodes, and then if you had a memory of four GPUs, you just need to consider if the biggest layer suite in the memory of your GPU. The con in this technique is, well, we are here loading from disk to memory and offloading and loading the next. So you are, in this case, we repeat the process three times per token with the cost of loading every layer from disk. The maximum speed today in almost April 2024 is 4 gigabytes per second from this to GPU to memory. You can do this as well as you want in CPU, because here we don't need to do quantization if you don't want. You can do it, but you don't need. This way you even don't lose precision in your weights. But consider that if we, for example, the model that we are I'm going to show you had, you can see here in the logs, the model had a safe tensor, a PyTorch tensor, this model is sharded as well. It had two shards, one is 10 gigabytes, the other one is 3.5, practically 14 gigabytes. So this model with the best SSD, the best storage, it will take approximately 4 seconds per loop. Just let's consider that you need 4 seconds, 4 gigabytes per second. We had 14, approximately 4 seconds to load the whole model in memory. But this is if you try to do it in only 4 chunks, no? But as you can see here, the model is divided in layers, no? What the technique is doing is just serializing every layer of the model. This model is a 7 billion models. I took it from, well, it's from the documentation. You can take a look. I'm posting you on the documentation the all these links. You can take whatever is available on the documentation. This is a model that you can download from Hugging Face, as you can see here. And then loading the model, what is essentially doing is splitting all the model in chunks, and every chunk is a layer of the original model. And then in this model with 7 billion, we have, as they say here, 35 layers. No? So the model is divided in 35 chunks. And the model, every token that you will generate at inference time will mean that you need to load the model, pass the data through the model and do the calculations, drop this layer from the GPU, and load the next one, do the calculations, and so on and so forth. So again, if we had in this case 35 steps, and well, the size of the chunks, I don't know if there is a place here where we can look at them. Maybe we can look at the disk, because finally this is a location in your file system. You can take a look and then, yeah, or make some simple calculations. Probably we make an error in some of them, but if we had 14 gigabytes and we had 35, just make the average and you will see that we had round about probably it's kind of 400 megabytes per layer, something like that, or slightly less. So every time that we we need to do 35 times per token loading and calculate the weights, no, and drop the layer, no. So this is incurring in additional time, which in my opinion still this technique is not ready for a production environment, no. And then let me just explain you how it's done. You just import the library, you import AutoModel. AutoModel is exactly the same, that but how to say, with this ability to do how to say, the using profiling underscore mod equal true. What it's doing is again splitting the model in layers in your disks. You just, and then on, you just use it exactly the same that you use another model. We see here we use the tokenizer. And here we generate model. Here you can see that I'm telling the function generate just to generate maximum 10 tokens. My input is what is the capital of Italy. And you can see here what is doing exactly is what I told you. If we say 10 times, we had 10 rounds of doing this process. And then finally, the time that it took, it was 1133 seconds in do the inference, and we get a response. You can try it at your home with a bigger model, only be ready that this model is round about, you can do the calculations here, all these files, you need to download it to your hard disk and do the splits, so it's gonna take some time. And then on, obviously, instead to generate 10 tokens, you want to generate 50, because you have a longer prompt, or you want to generate more text. This will mean, if you, for example, you want to generate 20 tokens, it is again, because you have a longer prompt, or you want to generate a little bit more text. Instead to be 1133, it will be two times and so on and so forth. So the technique is nice, is good. You can do text at in very cheap hardware, commodity, something that it is broken, you just change it for some hundreds of dollars or hundreds of pounds or euros, is practically nothing. But well, again, still I think is there is a lot of room to improve that to we can use this technique in a production system, because well, 11:33 seconds is practically 20 minutes to generate just 10 tokens, no, just to answer nine minutes, sorry, is 9 minutes to generate that. So still, you can run it, but still far from, in my opinion, not to be used it on production. And just imagine that we have this is a model of 7 billions. We have a model of 70 billions. I checked this model had 88 layers, so can be split it as well, similarly, let's say 90. So we probably multiply this by, but also the layer, you have to consider that these layers in this model of 70B maybe are bigger, and they are not well, they say that they try the people who create the library, they say that they try these guys who also create a research paper scaling large language model or low end commodity computers, and they may test, they also they give you the link to a notebook where they may test with Mistral, with Llama. There is a number of models that you they may test. You see here 70 billions, 35 billions, 34, sorry, 7 Mistral. We have here Godzilla. Well, some of these are already fine-tuned. The one we use, this one is fine-tuned as well. They say that is a, well, we use the 7 billion. This is the mix of the Llama 2 with the Platypus. There's the same for the 7 billions. Using also the equivalent versions in 7 billion. So okay, finally, what I want to say you that the technique is working, is quite interesting technique. As I say in previous videos where I touch this topic, there is a lot of people working and researching in how to optimize training, inference, and fine tuning, finding very creative ways on how to reduce time, reduce cost, use it in cheaper infrastructure that you can deploy easily and no need to invest millions millions like the Gemini need or GPT-4 or GPT-4.5 Turbo to be trained and to be fine-tuned. In this case, you can at least you can start to test. No? And then my opinion that we'll soon see, because this is progressing very fast, we will see that we will be able to start using this technique or something similar, because it's not only, this is one of the implementations of this technique, using the same concept, the same approach. There is some others that do some cross calculations and or use more GPUs also at different times, but well, with the cost of synchronization. But okay, there is other people as well who had other similar libraries using very similar approach to this. As I said, many people working on this, on optimization, on creating better techniques in attention layers, in how to save money, time, and reduce costs, especially because this activity, especially when we speak about large models with the billions of parameters, is an activity that is not a hand of or is only a hand of very big tech companies. And that's all. I hope that you like and you enjoy with the content. I find it very, very interesting stuff. And that's all for now. Thank you very much for watching. And as I say usually, if you like the video, just give me a like and subscribe to the channel if you didn't do it before. See you soon.